There are three types of caches as determined by the quantity E, which is the number of lines per set. So if E is equal to 1, we have only one line per set. This is referred to as direct mapped. And this is essentially the same as the lookup table that we discussed earlier. If we have multiple lines per set, so if E is greater than 1, we refer to it as set-associative. And so we'll need to check the tags because we will have multiple lines within each set. If the number of lines is if the number of sets is equal to the total capacity divided by the block size, then actually there's only one set. And this is a special case that's referred to as fully associative, because all of the lines in the cache are in the same set, and you basically don't have to do a set lookup. Okay, so let's look at each of these. So in the direct mapped case, we take the address, we split it into the tag, the set index, and the block offset, and we use the set index to look up the set that this particular address maps to. And there's only going to be one line inside of that set because there's one line per set as specified by E. So what this means is that we can immediately go to the set that we're trying to that corresponds to this address, and then we just need to check the tag and make sure that the tag matches the tag of the address we're trying to look up. We also need to make sure that the valid bit is set. So if things are both true, then we can read the data out of the cache starting at the block offset. Okay, so here's a question. So suppose we have a direct mapped cache with sets labeled starting at 0. So what set would we use to store a cached version of a data element stored at the address hex 4D6? And so here are some hints. So you should pause the video and see if you can figure this out. Okay, so we're told that the number of sets is 16, which means that the number of bits for the set index is going to be 4. We're also told that the block size is 1, so the number of bits for the block offset is actually 0, which means that this field doesn't actually consume any of the bits of the address. So basically, we can just look at the least significant bits, and in particular, we want the first 4 of them, which is actually exactly equivalent to what we did earlier, which is just extracting the low order 4 bits, which is the first hex digit, which is 6. So that is the set that we would use to store this data element. Okay, so if E is greater than 1, then we have a set-associative cache, which means that there are multiple cache lines inside of a set. And so here we have E equals 2, which means we have 2 lines per set, or we would also refer to this as two-way set-associative. So what this means is that we still have to do the lookup to figure out which set we're in, but then we also might need to check multiple lines inside of the cache to find the exact tag that we're looking for. And so this involves a little bit more work during the lookup. Okay, so here's another question. So suppose we have a four-way set associative cache with sets labeled starting at 0. So which set would we use to store the same address under this scheme? Well, so the lookup actually works exactly the same as last time, because the only difference now is that we're going to now need to examine those multiple lines inside of the cache in order to find the one that we're looking for. So we would still be looking for set number 6. Okay, so the last type of cache is the fully associative cache. This is when everything is in one set, and so we're always going to select that set, set 0, which means we don't actually need to reserve any of the bits for a set ID or a set index. Basically, all we're doing now is just looking through every single entry in the cache to check to see if the tag matches the tag from the address that we're looking for. If it does, and if the valid bit is set, then we can read the data again starting at the block offset. Okay, so suppose we have a fully associative cache with sets labeled starting at 0. So now which set would we use to store this this address? So take a second and see if you can figure this out. So this is again a little bit of a trick. This is a little bit of a trick question, actually, because there's only one set, and so we're always going to select set 0. So that is the set we would use in this case. Okay, you may be wondering why we use the middle bits for the set index. So the block offset may make sense because that's where we want to read inside of the cache line. So it makes sense to use the low order bits for that. But you may wonder, why don't we use the high order bits for the set index rather than sort of these middle bits? And the reason is that we really want contiguous memory blocks to map to different cache sets. And that's because of this idea of spatial locality. Things that are next to each other are probably going to be accessed in sequence. And so if we use the high order bits, we would put things that are in sequence into the same cache set, which is not going to be good because that means that we're going to have a lot of misses. However, if we use the middle bits, we'll get much better behavior because each of these contiguous elements is going to map to a different element in the set, and so we'll have fewer misses overall.